Will you as a developer really want people to see the images in your website like this? Yes? No? Well, unfortunately, this is what your images or videos will look like unless you consider different dimensions and image sizes when you write codes. Let's see how can we magically change images from looking ugly like this to looking nice and professionally positioned like this. If you're eager to master web development and programming, this channel is tailor-made for you. Just smash that subscribe button and watch amazing tutorials and prog bytes that will teach you how to code. Well, as you can see here, I have two divs which will contain our images. The first one is the normal and second one is the tall div, you can see them here. So let's add some images inside these divs. For example, the first div, let's add this image. And also let's open another tag here and let's paste different image here. So right now I have two images inside those containers, but they are looking ugly. So let's go inside our CSS code. So you can see that I have my normal and tall divs selected, and also their images, the images inside them. So let's give them some widths and heights. So 100% width, and also a height of 100%. And also let's just copy this and paste it right here. So you can see that we have our images inside our containers, but right now they're looking like this. So look at this image, it is completely squished down to fit in its container. And also if we expand our browser, oops, you can see that this image, it stretch out to fit in this container. So which means that if we shrink our browser, so they will shrink with browser, and if we expand it, so they will stretch. So this is the problem. Right now we can see that our image is looking terrible, both of them, they are looking terrible. So how can we fix this problem? So this is when the object fit property comes in. So let's bring our browser back. We have a very cool property in the CSS named object fit, and it's really, really, really important and useful property. And we can set our, we can position our images, we can show a part of our image, and we can decide whether we want to fill out all of the container with our image, or we want to not only our images, we can, if we have any videos, we can use this object fit property to our videos too. So this is the object fit property. It can take 5 values. The default is fill, so you can see that I'm styling this image, so nothing changes. So this is the fill. It will fill out the container regardless of the image's aspect ratio or the anything. If the browsers, if the container's width is increasing, so it will increase the width of the image, so it can destroy the aspect ratio, but it doesn't care. So, and if we shrink our browser, or if the container is shrinked down, so it will narrow down itself to fit in this container. So, but we don't want this, right? So we want to solve this problem. So this is the default value. The next value that can solve this problem is cover. So we can give this object fit a cover value, and you can see that it already solved the problem. So now our image is looking as it should be looked like. So it is the original aspect ratio of this image. It covers the entire container size, and also it keeps the dimensions of image as its original. So if we now decrease the browser size, you can see that it doesn't narrow down itself. It just trims the image, but it keeps the image aspect ratio. And if we expand our browser, you can see that still have the image dimensions. So this is the cover, and we can, let's apply this to this normal image tool. So we can just give it an object fit, and let's give it cover. So nothing changes in this, but if we for example, let's remove this object fit, and if we expand our browser, our image is looking like this. This is completely stretched down. And if we bring it back, so you can see that now we haven't destroyed the aspect ratio of our image. So it is not looking perfect, but at least we have our original image aspect ratio. So this is a plus, I think. So now let's see another another values for this property. So this is the cover. Next we have contain. This is a value which will contain the image size. So which means that when we give this object with a cover value, so it will cover the container with that image and it will keep its aspect ratios. But this contain, it just contains the image. It doesn't zoom in or zoom out the image. It just fits the image size with this container. So you can see that now this image width is fitting with the container's width. So it doesn't care about the these spaces right here. And if we, for example, let's change this to contain too. So let's change it to contain. You can see that now it's looking good. But if we expand our browser, so you can see that it just fits the height of this image with this container, and it doesn't care about these spaces, because if it fills these spaces with this image, so the image dimension will be removed. So it will lose its dimension. So now it's just keeping the image. It's just focusing about image. It doesn't care about the container's extra spaces or something like this. So let's bring it back and let's keep this cover. So this is the content. And next we have the scale down, and this is also just like content per value, so it just scales the image down to fit this container. So this is the scale down. And next we have none. So none is none, so it will behave like that. We haven't set the position of the image. It just zooms the image in order to fit this container. So you can see that the image was very big, so therefore it didn't change the image size. It just took the part of the image which was fed in this container, so it didn't care about the other parts of the image. So definitely it is not what we want. So let's keep it cover. So you can see that now we know all of the values for this object property, object fit property. But now you think that we have solved the problem, but I say no. We have two big problems right now. So you can see that now this image has two problems, at least this image. So the first one is that we are losing the head of this man. So this is one of the most important parts of this image. So this is the head, but we have lost that image because that part, because we have zoomed this image in to fit this container. So and also it has another property that if we shrink our browser, you can see that now we lost our this part of the image, which was the pip. So this man is smoking a pip. So this is also an important part of this image. So we don't want to lose any of this. So if we expand our browser, so we lose the head part. And if we shrink our browser, we lose this pip part. So it can be solved by another property. So here is when the object position property comes in. So we are in a normal image. We have a nice property 2 in here for object position. It takes two values from us. The first value will be the x dimension and the second value will be the y dimension. Right now by default they are 50% and 50%, so we can change these values. This is the default value, and we can bring the part of the image that we want to be shown inside this container. So for the x dimension, you can see that we want the very right part of this image to be shown. So which means that we need to set this to, for example, 100. You can see that now we are in the very right part of this image. So this is the right part of this image. So I think it is a little bit more. Let's keep it 80%. Let's see. You can see that now it's okay. And also now the x dimensions problem is solved. But if we expand our browser in full screen, you can see that we still don't have the head part. So this is the y dimensions problem. So if we set this to 0, which means that we will keep the very top part of the image, and if we keep it, if we write 100%, it will be very bottom of the image. So in this case we don't want to care about the bottom of this image, because we want to care about the top part of this image. So let's keep it 0. Right now nothing changes, but if we expand our browser, you can see that now we have both the head and the pip part. So these were the most important parts of this image. So if we expand our browser, you can see that it just arranged itself to fit in this container, and also so it shows the parts of the image that we wanted to show. So you can see now the first image problem is completely solved. And let's scan to this second image. So actually, I don't think that we need to change a lot of things in this image because it is already set 50-50. So let's see what is the problem with this image actually. So you can see that I think it doesn't have any problem. But for example, if you want to play with this, if you want to move it to right, to left, to top, to bottom, we can definitely change these values and it will affect this value. For example, let's give it 40, no, 45. Yeah, now it's looking perfect. So let's bring our browser back. So in the last, I want to mention that all of these properties and values that we saw here, they can be applied for both images and videos, which means that if we have video instead of this image, we can just do the same things as we did for these images, and it will be applied for the video too, and it will affect it. And all right, this was all I had for you today. I hope this video was helpful for you. If it was, make sure to give it a like. And also, if we want to see more videos just like this, then smash that subscribe button. Thank you so much and see you next week.